الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله أما بعد. I just want to give you a summary of what we have covered last night in regards to this topic of the Quran, because this is a class that has to do with the science of the Quran, tafsir, and other than that. So this topic is extremely, extremely, extremely important, because it has to do with the Quran and it has to do with the speech of Allah. And these are from the most fundamental principles of belief. And every Muslim, male and female, must know these matters. So Ahl al-Sunnah wal-Jama'ah, the people of the Sunnah, they believe the Quran is the speech of Allah. So they affirm that Allah speaks in a way that befits His Majesty. And the Quran is the speech of Allah, uncreated, means not created. When you say uncreated, means not created. طيب. Why would they say not created? They could have said Quran is the speech of Allah. It would be enough, no doubt, it would be enough. But the reason they mention not created, because there are deviant sects who say the Quran is created. You understand? So from those sects, those deviant sects, you have al-Jahmiyyah. Al-Jahmiyyah, they believe the Quran is created. And the reason they say all this, remember, al-Jahmiyyah, they don't affirm any names or attribute of Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Zero. Because they claim that they are free in Allah from deficiencies. And this is ajeeb. Very ajeeb. Look how the shaitan get the best out of them. Because they use theological rhetoric, philosophy, and intellectual reasoning. They say if we say Allah speaks, this would necessitate he will have a tongue. Look at their philosophy. And this would necessitate that he will be like humans. And we say to them, this is not the case. Because Allah said in Surah Shura, Ayah 11, ليس كمثله شيء وهو السميع البصير ليس كمثله شيء. There is nothing like unto him. So nothing and no one resembles the Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is nothing like unto him, meaning in every aspect, in his essence, in his names and attributes subhanahu wa ta'ala, because he is the creator. And the creator cannot be like the creation. For example, the creator doesn't have a beginning. And he doesn't have an end. The creation has a beginning and has an end. You see, the creation speaks. But their speech is not like the speech of the Lord, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then you can give other examples. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He hears in a way that befits His Majesty. We hear also, but our hearing is not like His hearing. He hears everything. Our hearing is limited. We can hear what's going on here in the masjid, but we cannot hear what's going on outside. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He hears everything. He sees everything. So the people of the Sunnah, they believe the Quran is the speech of Allah uncreated. The wording and the sound are from Allah and they are not created. Now you have the second deviant sect, Al-Mu'tazila. Al-Mu'tazila also, they believe the Quran is created. And they're very ajeeb. So they believe that the Quran that is not created is in the preserved tablets. That is not created. But what Jibreel brought from Allah and then Muhammad brought home Allah, that is created. A'udhu billah. And they say that Musa alayhi salatu was salam, the speech that he heard from the tree. This is ajeeb. It's very ajeeb. So the third ones are al-Ash'ara. And these guys, they have come up with a very strange belief. Very strange. So they say al-Quran is two parts. That which is uncreated and that which is created. So they say that which is created is what is in the Mus'haf and what the people recite. But the Quran that is not created is the internal speech of Allah. You understand what internal speech means? You don't get it. They're going to confuse you, huh? Okay. Internal speech is what Allah wanted to say. You understand? Okay. Now they say the Quran is the internal speech of Allah. This one is uncreated. But that which is in the masahif, like those masahif there, they said this is created. And that's what Yusuf Estes said. Same thing. Do you know what he said, right? Mm-hmm. Okay, what did he say?
About
the Quran. What did he say about the Quran?
What Allah means.
Yes, he said, I'm going to tell you what he said. Yusuf Estes has so many followers and he's misguiding so many of them. He said what is in the Mus'haf is not Quran. But it represents the Quran. This is the belief of Al-Ash'ara. Same thing. And he said the Quran is what's in the preserved tablets. He said the recital is not the Quran. It represents the Quran. And then he gave an example. He said like paper money. The value is not in the paper, in the cash that you get out of that paper. Look at this guy. So what he wants to say, that what is in the Mus'haf is not Quran. But it represents the speech of Allah. But it's not the speech of Allah. The speech of Allah is the internal speech. Alhamdulillah, Ahl-Sunnah, they don't have this philosophy. Ahl-Sunnah, they believe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks in a way that befits His Majesty, and the Quran is His speech. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَإِنْ أَحَدٌ مِنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ اسْتَجَارَكَ فَأَجِرُوا حَتَّى يَسْمَعَ كَلَامَ اللَّهِ. And if one of the mushrikeen, the polytheist, comes to you for protection, give him shelter until he hears the speech of Allah. So Allah called the Quran His speech. So if it is the speech of Allah, it cannot be created, because Allah is not created and His attribute cannot be created. This is the belief of Al-Sunnah wal-Jama'ah. How many Muslims know this belief? Not many. You will be shocked. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us all al-ilm al-nafi' wal-amal salih. Alhamdulillah rabbil alameen. Sallallahu ala Muhammad wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Jazakum Allah khair.